Good day, fellow students. Mabuhay sa inyong lahat. Welcome to our program, Science, Technology, and Society. In the previous episode, they discussed about the nanotechnology. Nanotechnology refers to the science, engineering, and technology conducted at the nanoscale, which is about 1 to 100 nanometers. In this episode, just stay tuned and let us discuss of you the world of the aspect of gene therapy in the science, technology, and society.
Let us first define what is gene therapy. Gene therapy is an experimental technique that uses gene to treat or prevent disease. In medical science has detected many human disease-related defective genes. These type of disease are not curable by traditional methods like taking readily available medicines. Gene therapy is a potential method to either treat or cure genetic-related. In 2015, a team of researchers at the Harvard Medical School and the Boston Children's Hospital stated that they were able to restore basic hearing in genetically deaf mice using gene therapy. The Boston Children's Hospital research team also reported that they have a restored level of hearing down to 25 decibels, which is actually equivalent to a whisper. The use and improved gene therapy vector development at the Massachusetts Ear and Eye that was identified as ANCAT, which enables the transfer of genes to the inaccessible outer hair cells when introduced into the cochlea, according to Flesser 2017. Human gene therapy was actually first realized in 1971. When the first recombinant DNA experiments were planned. It can be simply viewed as insertion foreign DNA into a patient tissue that hoped to successfully eradicate the targeted diseases. It was actually inspired by the success of recombinant DNA technology, which occurred over the last 20 years. Without a doubt, gene therapy is the most promising yet possibly unfavorable medical field being studied.
According to Flesser 2017, there are several approaches to gene therapy. The replacement of mutated gene that can cause withheld copy of the gene and activation of it of a mutated gene that is functioning improperly and introducing a new gene into the body to help fight a disease.
General, a gene cannot be directly inserted into a human's gene or cell. A gene is inserted into another gene using a carrier or vector. At present, the most type of vector our viruses have involve a way of encapsulating and transporting their genes to human cell in a pathogenic manners.
Viral vectors. The host cell will carry out and produce additional copies of the virus, leading to more and more cells becoming infected. And the non-viral vectors methods present certain advantages over viral methods: simple, large-scale production, and low host immunogenicity being just 2.
First is somatic gene therapy. The somatic gene therapy involves the manipulation of genes in cells that will be helpful to the patient but not inherited to the next generation. Treatment of human disease by transferring of DNA to somatic cell. It is actually the process of delivering good genes into targeted cells for treatment purpose. Types of somatic gene therapy. Number one, ex vivo. Exterior target cells are removed from the patient's body, modified outside the body, and transplanted back in again. Target tissues of ex vivo is bone marrow, stem cells, blood vessel, smooth muscle cells, and liver cells. Method of ex vivo gene therapy. First, pure cells are collected from the patient to avoid rejection. The cells are grown in culture cells were integrated with vector, the vector carrying original genes and back in patients. Advantage of ex vivo gene therapy. Target selectively specific cell types. Cells are collected from the patient to avoid rejection. Disadvantage of ex vivo gene therapy causes distress to patient, costly, complex process. The number two, in vivo, interior, genes are directly transferred to the cells and the patient body. Method of in vivo gene therapy, first injection of naked DNA into tumor by simple needle and syringe. Second, by using biolistic gene gun and prepelled DNA coated on the surface of gold pellets. Third, DNA transfer liposome. Fourth, viruses are genetically engineered virus, so it's not replicate once inside the host. Advantage of in vivo gene therapy, sample involving direct vector, injection minimal, invasiveness, same location can be injected more than once. Disadvantage of in vivo therapy requires additional safety regulation, transgene expression by vectors, need to contain internal tissue-specific inducible promoters, target tissue, skin, lung, muscle, liver, spleen. Advantage of somatic gene therapy, number one, non-productive. Number two, does not get passed on to next generation. Number three, targeted to specific organ or tissue. Number four, does not affect germline. Disadvantage of somatic gene therapy, number one, effect are short-lived. Number two, transporting gene to the target cells are difficult.
Germline gene therapy is when DNA is transferred into the cell that produces reproductive cells, eggs, or sperm in the body. This type of therapy allows for the correction of disease, causing gene variants that are certain to be passed down from generation to generation. But when the child becomes in 20 to 30 years old, he or she can acquire the high blood, but with the help of gene therapy, the diseases that you have get in your parent and it passed to you will disappear. It is a kind of therapy that will help to disappear that kind of diseases.
Stem cell is a cell with a unique ability to develop into specialized cell types in the body. In the future, they may be used to replace cells and tissues that have been damaged or lost due to disease. Our body is made up of many different types of cells. Most cells are specialized to perform particular functions, such as red blood cells that carry oxygen around our bodies in the blood, but they are unable to divide. Stem cells provide new cells for the body as it grows and replace specialized cells that are damaged or lost. They have two unique properties that enable them to do this. They can also divide over and over again to produce new cells. And the last one is, as they divide, they can change into other type of cells that make up of that body.
Embryonic stem cells supply new cells for an embryo as it grows and develops into a baby. These stem cells are said to be pluripotent, which means they can change into any cells in the body. Adult stem cells supply new cells as an organism grows and to replace cells that get damaged. Adult stem cells are said to be multipotent, which means they can only change into some cells in the body, not any cell, for example, blood or hematopoietic stem cells can only replace the various types of cells in the blood. Skin or epithelial stem cells provide the different types of cells that make up our skin and hair. Induced pluripotent stem cells, or iPS cells, are stem cells that scientists make in the laboratory. Induced means that they are made in the lab by taking normal adult cells like skin or blood cells and reprogramming them to become stem cells. Just like embryonic stem cells, they are pluripotent so they can develop into any cell type. There are ethical issues in gene therapy, and the ethical questions surrounding gene therapy, it may include, how can good and bad uses of gene therapy be distinguished? Who decides which traits are normal and which constitute a disability or disorder? Will the high cost of gene therapy make it available only to wealthy? Could be widespread use of gene therapy make society less accepting of people who are different? Should people be allowed to use gene therapy to enhance basic human traits such as height, intelligence, or athletic ability? The idea of germline therapy is controversial. While it could spare future generations in a family from having a particular genetic disorder, it might affect the development of fetus in unaccepted ways. Because people who would be affected by germline gene therapy are not yet born, they can't choose whether to have the treatment. Because of these ethical concerns, the U.S. government does not allow federal funds to be used for research on germline therapy in people.
Before my name is Brian, let us have a short recap.
Gene therapy is a method of that may treat or cure genetic-related human illnesses. There are two forms of gene therapy. One is somatic gene therapy, which involves the manipulation of genes in cells that could be helpful to the patient but not inherited to the next generation. The other is germline gene therapy, which involves the genetic modification of germ cells or the origin cells that will pass the change to the next generation. Stem cell is a cell with the unique ability to develop into specialized cell types in the body. In the future, they may be used to replace cells and tissues that have been damaged or lost due to disease. There are three main types of cells. Number one is embryonic stem cells. Number two is adult stem cells. And number three, induced pluripotent stem cells. There are many ethical issues on the gene therapy. Some of these issues are about questions on whose authority or power to decide which human traits should be altered. Other concerns are on the discriminatory effects of those who may not or cannot avail gene therapy.
I hope that you will learn about this episode about the aspect of gene therapy. So thank you for watching and goodbye.